to my son, Joshua Davis. Do you want to introduce yourself? Okay. All right, Joshua, how old are you?
7 years old. About to turn 8, and I am currently in second grade.
Can you tell us a little bit about what living with type 1 diabetes is like for you?
Well, diabetes is really hard to live with, and it's just that, like my mom said, I was about to die, but we handled it.
We did handle it. Okay. Tell them a little bit about your day at school.
I have to go to the clinic a lot to test, and if I'm low, when I test, like under 100, I have to wait 15 minutes before I test again, so that means I'm missing school time and recess.
Well, you're missing school time. That doesn't seem so bad, does it?
It might seem bad. It might seem like, whatever. But I usually miss math, which is one of my favorite subjects.
Mm-hmm. Yep. Because math is right after recess. And you see, no matter how hard we try, we're giving free carbs before recess. We're doing all kinds of stuff to try and keep him elevated. But what happens after recess almost every single day? That's right. And so you have to eat, even when you're not hungry?
Yep.
How do you feel when you're low?
Yucky.
And what about when you're super high?
When I'm super high, my head hurts and my tummy hurts.
Yeah. And Joshua, can you tell us a little bit about why you were excited to be a part of the artificial pancreas trial?
Because the algorithm of the pancreas, artificial pancreas, make sure that it does whatever it can to make me not go high and low. That's what I was most excited about.
That's right. So what were some of the activities? You were there for 3 days, right? What were some of the activities that you did while you were there?
Soccer. I did rock climbing. I did putt-putt. But I only went low once.
The whole time?
The whole time.
The whole time you were there?
And it was only 70.
And you only went to 70?
Mm-hmm.
Wow. And do you remember what your blood sugar looked like on your graph? Do you remember wearing your...
Mm-hmm. I'm pretty sure it was only like...
Not even that big, right? It was more like more like hills, right? Like little teeny tiny hills?
Yeah.
Versus the big huge spikes, right? This is Joshua's favorite part. Right. Okay, so let's talk about how you felt when you were at the trial.
I felt really good. I never felt icky. I never had tummy aches. I never had headaches.
And did you have to stop doing activities like you do at home?
No.
No, you just got to play right through it, right?
Mm-hmm.
Do you remember why you got to play right through it?
Because I never went low.
Well, right, you didn't go low. But what did the artificial pancreas do for you?
It extended the boluses.
Well, it gave you the insulin, right? Or took insulin off, right? It automatically thought for you while you were playing. And it guessed what your insulin was going to do ahead of time, right? What your body was going to do.
It's kind of like a future teller.
A future teller? Okay, tell us more about that.
Like, it can tell when you're about to go low, when you're about to go high, like what you're about to be.
And it corrected for that, right?
Mm-hmm.
That's awesome. Talk to us a little bit about what happens overnight when you're trying to sleep and you're high or you're low.
I have to be woken up at midnight and 3 a.m. and get tested. And sometimes that means I have to eat too.
So then let's talk real quick about what it was like overnight with the artificial pancreas when we were at the trial.
I didn't have to wake up. No alarms. We didn't even have to be tested.
You didn't have to get tested overnight? Why? Do you remember why?
Because we trusted the artificial pancreas.
Right, because we could trust the system that UVA put out. It was an amazing program. It was an amazing system. We could see exactly what was going on. Now, don't get me wrong. It also helped that we had an amazing team in a locked door in another, in part of the hotel that were keeping an eye on them, and thumbs up to our team back there. But as a mom, it was really difficult for me to give up that control that first night and to trust that the system was going to work. And this is the only thing that he's ever known. He was 11 months old when he was diagnosed. So every single night from the time that he was 11 months old until that night, we tested him at midnight and 3 a.m. to keep him alive. And in order to be able to trust that system, it was amazing. And to be able to see that straight line and to know that he didn't have those mountains, we weren't in danger of going low, I think your words were very correct in being able to have that overnight control and having that overnight faith in the system. So, Joshua, do you have anything else that you want to add to these nice people?
I just wanted to say thank you for the artificial blankets.